time to head through the door. And Dagothur is directly up ahead waiting.
Welcome, Moon and Star, to this place where destiny is made.
And if you didn't pick it up already, Dagothur loves long speeches. The first thing he says is that even though way back when we talked to Dagoth Gares, he gave us a message that Dagothur is willing to extend his hand in friendship, that's no longer the case, and Dagothur is going to kill us now. He also gives us several final questions, and there are several ways to answer them. You can be all heroic, you can kiss the Empire's ass, you can give strange answers don't mean anything. But whatever answers you give don't actually influence what happens along the game. They don't really mean anything, so you can just pick whatever answer you want and nothing changes. You can also ask him several questions, but it isn't really anything you don't already know. Dagothur is just being evil, wants to take over the world. It's the same story we've been hearing this whole time now. Then once we're done, we can begin the battle. Now, Dagothur says that we can give the first blow, but because of the way the AI works, we have only a small time frame to actually do that. He'll start attacking us anyway. And here he comes. So, fun fact. Right now, I am at level 13, but the game sort of implies that you're not supposed to really begin the final part of it and heading to a mountain until you're about level 20. So I'm a little more than half of the level I'm supposed to be at this point in the game. Yep, just like I said, using that fireball spell from the beginning of the game on the final boss. And thanks to my new steel life sword, Dagothur is not a problem at all, as corpse disappears into the room next door. So, when I go through these doors right here, a number of things are going to happen in very quick succession, and Dagothur is going to be talking pretty much the entire time, so I won't really have a chance to commentate on what's going on. The first thing that's going to happen is that Dagothur will be directly ahead of us. He's going to start casting very bad fireball spells at us. The second thing is that Akulakan, or the second Iminium as I called him in the last video, is going to be in the very center of the room, and I'm going to levitate up to it and head over to the Heart of Lorcan, which is going to be in the very center of whatever progress on Akulakan Dagothur has made. The third thing that's going to happen is I'm going to put on Wraithguard and hit it with Sunder. As soon as I hit it with Sunder, Dagothur is going to teleport directly behind my character and start attacking it with melee attack, and also a couple spells. So if you see my character's health start to go down mysteriously, that's the reason why. And finally, I'll hit it several times with Keening, and the heart will be destroyed and Dagothur will be defeated. And so I will take care of all of this hard work while you guys get to sit back and enjoy the view. And do at least take a look at the room I'm in as I sort of go around and do all this stuff. This is my favorite room in the entire game. The developers did a really great job sort of designing for the magnitude of what goes on in it.
What a fool you are.
I'm a god. How can you kill a god? What a grand and intoxicating innocence. How could you be so naive? There is no escape. No recall or intervention can work in this place. Come, lay down your weapons. It is not too late for my mercy. What are you doing? What are you doing? Fool! Stop!
We did it. The Heart of Lorcan has been destroyed. Dagothir has been defeated. The way has been stopped on Vardenfell, and we have completed the Nerevarim prophecy. All that's left to do is turn the crank and head into this chamber. Now, when I approach that door right over there, the Daedric Goddess Azura is actually going to appear right in front of the door and give us a ring. And the ring's not that important, it just gives us the ability of Night Eye, which makes everything look blue, and I think it also restores fatigue whenever you have it on. But it's a nice ring to signify that you completed the main quest of Morrowind. Anyway, that does it for this LP. I hope you guys had as much fun as I did. This is Musical Daredevil signing off.